He could not cease. It was from the soul being comforted. He couldn't find comfort. You know, that's hard sometimes to find comfort. Sometimes there's hard even to find peace when you're a child of God. But as he went on, he said, I called to remembrance my song in the night. Then he began to commune with his own heart, and he began to meditate upon what he had said. Then he began to do something that we all do. We began to diligently search, and that's what he did. He began to search to see what it was. And then all at once he began to say this. He said, will the Lord cast off forever, and will he be favorable no more? Well, friends, I can say this of God. You know, it doesn't matter how long of the trial. It doesn't matter how long the valley or how dark the way. One thing we can rest in sure is that this right here, that when our soul does get like that, and we might ask the question sometimes, because David did in Psalms 22 and 1. So did Christ. When he was in the Garden of Gethsemane. There's sometimes it's not wrong to question why you're going through something or other. But you always got to remember God has a plan for your life. But he said right here, he said, will the Lord cast off forever? No, he won't. No, the Lord will not cast off forever. Because, my friends, he loves his people, and he will not cast them off. And said, will he be favorable no more? Yes, he will be favorable. Because weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Is his mercies clean gone forever? Friends, no, because the Bible tells us that he delights in mercy, and not only that, and will he be favorable no more? His favor is upon his children, friends. Is his mercies clean gone forever? His promises, are they failing? No, I would say unto this psalmist, have he forgotten to be gracious? No, he has not forgotten to be gracious. When it seemed like that there was no hope, God sent forth his son, born under the law, to redeem mankind. Friend, yes, he is gracious and full of mercy. And he said in verse 10, this is my infirmities, but I will remember the years of the right hand of the Most High. And I will remember the works of the Lord. Surely I will remember the wonders of old. And then he said in verse 12, I will meditate also on thy works and talk of thy doings. Then when he began to consider, who God was, and forgot about the eyes and the mice, and began to look, stood of looking down for pity, instead of looking down, when he began to meditate, remember the wonders of old. Said, I will meditate also on thy works, and I'll talk of thy doing. He said, thy ways in verse 13, O God, is in the sanctuary. who is so great a God as our God. Amen. You've got to remember who you belong to. You've got to remember who you're serving. Amen. When you get past the eyes and the minds and look up and remember thy way, O God, friend, the clouds will depart. Friend, listen. Some people say, preacher, I've been in this storm so long, I don't think I'm ever going to see any light. But my friend, let me assure you, on the authority of God's word, amen, Jesus Christ is the light of the world. Friend, His light will dispel the gloom and the doom. Friend, listen, it might be a storm that you're in, like this man was. Sleep left him. He mused and he took, meditated, sleep had left him, and he began to wonder where God is. But he began to think on what God